OS with. Kuro had some really good games on the into any offensive itemization outside of Wit's End now, so less of a pick. Here comes Kuro.
There you go, yeah, that's going to be a gank coming up the top lane. Kuro and Spirit here jump on top of Helper. The wall's there, nowhere for him to go. That's first blood over to Afrika Freaks as Talia picks it up. By Spirit, Marin did back off. Now Malrong coming around the side, does not have the smite, will not be able to take this away, and Kuro's going to back him up. Malrong, does he want to pursue this? As the Stand United coming through, dashes forward, gets on top of Spear, and he gets taken out. Septon finding the kill now, slowing up Kuro with that newfound red. Yeah, and now they're just looking for more in the mid lane. Sonic Wave comes through, kick back on the Dragon's Rage. Kuro goes down, and Septon finds a second kill, nicely executed by Malrong.
Cleanly sin. Damage. It is faster to take, but still a lot to learn about it as an objective.
Oh, that's going to be the flash forward here. Unleash Power comes through, they get the stun. And that's going to be the Resonating Strike from Malrong straight in underneath the turret. They find a kite back a little bit, delay this take on the turret. Meanwhile, Helper all on his lonesome down in the bottom lane. Draven ult not going to connect, but it doesn't really matter. Kramer still comes up.
And the barrier wasn't used, but obviously not to know at that time.
It was really close, so better safe than sorry. But that just means that Kuro's going to be that much more susceptible to being ganked. Speaking of which, Spirit tries to run at the Syndra, but...
looking for a pick. They also have Marin coming up.
Pitching down from below, dashes forward, gets in on top of Malrong, at least for the start, okay. But Tucson walking in by himself, gets absolutely destroyed by the Syndra. Now Ever-8 going to seek to turn this one around. Malrong throws out that Sonic Wave, lands in onto Coral.
There's trades between him and Shen, because Marin's two levels up and plenty of items.
Well, duels walking forward, Junk's starting to come through here from Kramer, answers that 90 caliber net. Now that Stand United coming down onto the Caitlyn, but it's not going to be in time. He already gets taken out, the kill goes over to Spirit. Ella going low, gets taken out, the cash in coming through from Kramer. Big burst of gold. This looks like the answer is going to be yes. Everybody piling in. Marin waiting over the wall to come in from behind. TP's going to be burned out here by Helper. Trying to join in. Throws out that
nice turn.
Unleash Power. Finds the first kill in onto Tucson. Now Septon running for his life. Grand Challenge was thrown down. The kickback comes through for the Dragon Rage. But Marin dashes forward, completes the challenge, finds the kill in onto the Syndra. And the rest of Ever-8 have to kite back.
Game's at right now.
Marin just trying to take away as much as he possibly can. Moves over to the red buff. Gets that one out. Taunt comes through. Do they want to try to collapse onto this? The stun comes down, and Septon finds the kill. His fifth of the game. 5-1 and 3 on the Baron.
We turn onto it now. Baron damage is decent on their side, but now we're going to see Afrika with the contest.
12 seconds here on Marin. Still has the TP available, and there's a ward in the pit that has not been cleared. Weaver's wall comes down, cutting them off inside the pit. Septon going to have to do some nice gatekeeping. The hook going wide. Baron goes low. Marin even to finish this one off, and now Spirit walking forward, but has to kite out of there as best as he can, but he does not get anything, goes down in the exchange, and Septon finds another kill. Now Marin coming in from the sideline, will dash forward, getting locked down immediately, gets that riposte off, but still can't mitigate enough. He gets taken out as Malrong finds the kill, two dead on the side of Afrika Freaks. And
I mean, they'll disengage. So many fed damages.
Oh, locked down over the wall. That's going to be the unleashed power yet again from Septon. Just riptable spot. Still one miraculous team fight from the side of Afrika Freaks. Could turn the tide of this, but now Marin getting caught is just going to put a cork in that one. He goes down. Malrong finding the kill. Says, you know what, Septon, you got to share these.
No fights in this game at all.
Here we go. Weaver's wall thrown down here by Kuro. A bit blind, but actually just cut Septon off from the fight. The rest of the team collapsing in from the top. Malrong goes down, gets the kick in, straight onto Kuro, into the face of Septon, and he takes him out. Dark Passage will yank Spirit out to safety, but now with Kuro taking down all of that poke damage that Afrika need to rely on around this Baron is gone. They'll go ahead and start this one up.
Yeah, let's see if Olaf goes for another Express Engage, because this Baron's going down fast.
I mean, look at the trap line thrown down here from Duel, just trying to keep them gated out. Tucson goes low, one more hit would have finished them off. Ace in the hole comes through, but Kramer there to body block for his support.
0-1-4. Nothing to write home about. Malrong and Septon. It's been about the duo. We talked about how clean they were, how their understanding was. Playing around the mid lane and forcing Kuro behind. Kuro might have made it a bit easier with the self-counter pick, but let's focus on what's good, and that is Ever-8. Looks like they're one.
Be able to find it here. But now look at all those super creeps. Four in this bottom lane wave getting ready to push forward.
Yeah, the desperation's there from the side of Afrika. That much is clear.
Weaver's wall not quite going to cut off those super creeps, however. So they're still pushing in. Getting ready to eat those turret shots. Q comes over from Septon, jumps out to Sin. As they push in for the finish, that's going to be the ultimate coming out. Unleash Power in on the Kuro, jumps him down to about half HP, but can't follow up for much more because the Devourer has to come down. Now Marin and Spirit pushing forward, looking desperately for a kill onto the carries, but they're cutting back into the back line so effectively now. Flashing forward his duel, finds the double kill, finally putting some kills on the board for himself. Will not finish with zero, but they will close out the game. 43 minutes just about from Ever 8, tripling the kills of a Freak of Freaks.
And the curveballs in the draw for a Freak of Freaks did not pan out, and the curveball in the game was the level of play from Ever 8. They look significantly worse than, say, Jin Air, for example. They're very comfortably qualified for LCK Summer. It was much more toiling for the side of Ever 8 winners, but you can see the team looks pretty jazzed, and they have a lot to be proud of because their preparation and just the level of clean macro, inspired play between Sceptred and Malrang, Ever 8 winners, you wanted to put them in that 9th or 10th space box that previously Kongdu Monster occupied, and suddenly, it's only a single game, it's only the start of the season, but there's a lot to like about the side of Ever 8, and on the side of Afrika, they tried a lot of things at once. Risky draft, low wave clear, the Draven and the Fiora at the same time, self-counter picking in mid lane, and they were put to the sword, so well played to Ever 8. Not going to pass the judgment on either. We got a